In today's video, how many protein, carb, and fat should you eat to lose body fat? Hey guys, what's going on? This is Paul Rabella from ProPhysique.com. In today's video, I'm gonna break down exactly how many protein, how many carb, and how many fat you should be eating to lose body fat. And today's question comes from right here on my Instagram direct message. And if you love this content about nutrition and training to reach your goals, using an evidence-based approach, hit subscribe. It's what I love to do here. And yesterday's video got such a great response. And all I did was I took one of the questions I got off my Instagram and basically broke down how I would make changes. Now, yesterday was a fairly overweight female, right? And she had lost a lot of weight. And so her issues were a little bit different. So I wanted to give a different side of the coin. I got this great question from a gentleman. So I'm gonna read it and then we're gonna discuss it. Hey Paul, I'm 5'7", 163 pounds. I'm very active. I work out every single day doing calisthenics, but I'm struggling to lose body fat. I'm trying to get abs to pop out, but I'm not sure how much calories, protein, carbs, and fat I should eat. I've managed to lose some fat, but I've been trying for months and I don't know what to do. All right, well, first of all, the first thing I did was I went to this person's kind of profile because I wanted to get an outlook of kind of how they looked. And the first thing I found was that indeed he's very active. I saw he's like on a baseball team and young. I guess he's in high school, so I'm guessing around 18, 19 years old around there. So that immediately gives me a lot of information. Plus you told me your height and your weight and your goal, so I can really break this down. And I'm gonna put an exact plan in the description box, but where did I get this plan from? And here is the thing as a coach. I work with clients who give me a lot of information. We set up an initial phone call. All the coaches for ProPhysique do this. And so without having this advantage, what I've done is I've created something for you guys that you can use right now. If you go to ProPhysique.com, you can scroll down the website and you will find a calorie calculator based on the information that you plug in. So what I did was I took this gentleman's information, I went to the website, I plugged it in, and here's what I would like you guys to do to break it down to make it even better for you. So once I got the calorie total, based on this gentleman's height and weight and goals, he wants to lose body fat. It said that his calorie intake to do that should be around 2,460 calories. Great, now we know a starting position. Now I know what a lot of you are thinking. Well, how do you know that's right? Honestly, you don't know it's right. The best thing you can do is create a plan, follow it for a week or two, and see what happens. If you start dropping weight too quickly, well, maybe you need to eat a little bit more. If you're not dropping weight at all, well, that means that the calorie deficit actually isn't good enough. So maybe you need to be more active or decrease your calories, but you have to start somewhere. You can't just always be wondering about what the perfect plan is. This seemed very reasonable for me based on age and based on all the information that I got. But how do you hit those 2,460 calories? What do you do? Is it going to be all carbs, all fats, no protein? Of course not. We need to have the right micronutrient breakdown. And this is where a lot of confusion can come in. How much protein, carbs, and fats? And that's exactly what this gentleman wanted to know. And I'm gonna tell him exactly. Now I'm putting the plan below, but I'm gonna tell you guys right here. Now at 167 pounds or so, I would put protein right at around a gram per pound of body weight because he is in pretty good shape, okay? So it's not as if he's very overweight. If someone's very overweight, I might drop the protein below their body weight, right? But for this gentleman, I'm putting the protein right around 180 grams, okay? That is a nice amount of protein. That is gonna give us satiety. I would break those meals up into about 4 meals a day, okay, of large doses of protein broken up every 4 or 5 hours. That's typically what I do, 3 to 4 big meals a day. That's what I like to do. Now, that leaves us with a lot of extra calories, okay? Our protein is set. Before I worry about the carbohydrates, I worry about the fat, because there are certain thresholds where you do not want to go below when it comes to fat intake. Fat is responsible for many things in our body. It aids in digestion. It's responsible for the cascade of hormones that are created. So I don't really like to go below 20 to 25% of your daily calories from fat. If we set his calories from fat at 25%, that gives us 70 grams of fat. Then we take the remaining calories and we apply that to carbohydrates. That gives us 280 grams of carbohydrates. Now, I would also break those up fairly evenly, probably not trying to get more than 100 grams in any sitting, just to make sure that we're not lethargic or anything through the day, make sure that we have good energy for training. But if we are eating some meals that are broken down in this manner, where we're having 40 to 50 to 60 grams of protein in a sitting, you know, 60, 70, 80 grams of carbs, 20, 25 grams of fat in a single meal, those are some high quality meals. And if you're using good sources, you're making sure you're getting some whole grains, making sure you're getting foods that you digest, your fiber, your lean sources of protein, man, this is going to be a fantastic place for you to be to get started. Now you just need to set up a consistent pattern so that you can track your calories. I would also track your cardio and your activity levels, okay? Because what we need to do is get a baseline of information. We need to make this as black and white as possible. What are your macros every day? What is your activity every day? Then we look at the data after that. This is how it works. You only have this information to go on. Don't trust that the calculator that I gave you is 100% accurate. Don't trust that MyFitnessPal is telling you what to eat and what not to eat and how much cardio to do, right? What you need to do is give yourself consistent numerical data, and then you can focus on fat loss. Now, if your goal is to see your abs, but you're also still trying to perform in calisthenics, you really want to make sure that you're not losing body fat too quickly. Now, the online calculator that I provided on my website, it actually sets weight loss at about a pound per week. If you want to be more aggressive, you could do that. I would still not suggest going too crazy with the calories, though. You can certainly, though, increase your activity levels, right? Getting up and doing cardio, waking up in the morning, going for a walk, taking more walks throughout the day, really being aware of how many steps you're taking along with your calisthenics. Don't be afraid of cardio. You will not lose muscle as long as you're eating your protein, and we set it at 118, 180. That is a fantastic amount of protein. And also, as long as you are continuing to do the training that you were doing before, any type of calisthenics, any type of resistance training that you're doing is going to ensure that you're continuing to build, break down, and recover that muscle, so it's not going to be lost through the process of fat loss. The worst thing we can do when we enter a fat loss phase is do some type of crash diet where not only are we losing weight on the scale and we're seeing that number drop drastically and we're losing body fat, but we're also losing lean body mass, because the body does not like this. And when you go to put weight back on and you don't have as much lean body mass, it's going to overcorrect and increase your body fat to make up for that gap. It's a pretty straightforward answer for my friend here on how to get started. It really comes down to putting in the work, okay? I know it can be annoying to track your diet, and sometimes it honestly seems overwhelming. I remember the first time that I went through it, and even to this day, when I know I'm gonna start a fat loss phase like the one I'm on now for my 90-day transformation challenge, which is going well, and I plan to do a full day of eating for you guys and give you lots of information about what's going on. I've just been so busy with work. But whenever I'm about to enter that and I start getting a little bit more diligent with my tracking, there is a sense of like, okay, I've gotta put the work in. But I just know how well it works. And honestly, if you say you have a goal, but you're not willing to make some changes and put in some work to get there, then you don't really have a goal. You've got a pipe dream and it's full of shit. Put in the work to get the goal done, okay? I promise you, everything that you do to work towards that goal, all the work that you put in, will be rewarded. All right, guys? That's gonna be it for me today. I hope you guys are having an awesome Thursday. And I got a cool video planned for tomorrow as well, so I'll talk to you then.